the 14th of July, 1789, thousands of Parisians seized the Bastille fortress in Paris, the most famous moment of the revolution of 1789. The French Revolution is one of the great turning points in history. It continues to fascinate us, to inspire us, at times to horrify us. Hello, my name's Peter McPhee, and my course will introduce you to this extraordinary period of history. I'm standing in front of a portrait of Le Bray, father and son, in the National Gallery of Melbourne, Australia. It was done by Rigaud, one of Louis XIV's court painters. The father was a noble judge of the highest court in the kingdom. His son succeeded him. This was a world of aristocratic power and privilege. The revolution shattered this world. Never before had the people of a large and populous country sought to remake their society on the basis of the principles of liberty and equality. The drama, success, and tragedy of the revolution has attracted students to it for more than two centuries. Its importance and fascination for us are undiminished as we try to understand revolutions in our own times. In this course, we will ask three key questions. First, why was there a revolution in 1789? Ever since several thousand armed Parisians seized the Bastille fortress, people have debated the origins and meaning of what had happened. But they agree that the Declaration of the Rights of Man was a revolutionary statement about a totally different new society to be achieved. Second, why did the revolution continue after 1789? In the years after 1789, people could not agree on the practical application of the principles of the Declaration of the Rights of Man, driving the revolution in new directions. Opponents of change inside and outside France forced governments to take measures to preserve the revolution itself, culminating in the most controversial period of all, the Terror of 1793-94. This involved the greatest painter of the age, Jacques-Louis David, who famously captured the assassination of Jean-Paul Marat, one of the actions that led to the Terror. Third, what was the significance of the revolution? By the time Napoleon Bonaparte seized power in 1799, how revolutionary were the changes? Look at this portrait of Louis XVI from 1774, and now one of Napoleon from 1810. Did the similarities suggest that little had changed? Did the political instability of these years disguise a more fundamental social and economic stability? Was the French Revolution a major turning point in French, even world history, or instead just a protracted period of violent upheaval and warfare which wrecked millions of lives? I look forward to exploring these questions with you.